For many of us, buying a home is part of the American dream, but sometimes that dream can feel more like a nightmare.
Many homeowners across the Commonwealth are facing tough choices because their biggest investment has become their biggest financial drain. Eyewitness News reporter Kelly Choate is here now with this iTeam investigation. Kelly?
Good evening, Nick and Candace. In a perfect world, your house should never be worth less than your mortgage. But a new study shows that Monroe County has more upside-down homes than almost any other county in the nation. And other parts of northeastern and central Pennsylvania aren't doing much better.
I have a nice pot of pasta fazzola on if you want.
Oh, that looks good.
Carrie Gowardi is giving me the grand tour of her Scranton home. She and her husband Mark bought this property in the Trips Park section about 15 years ago.
I figured it would be a great house to, you know, spend the rest of our life here, raise the kids.
And for the most part, it has been.
My firstborn, Jillian, she's the 27 now. That's Winter, she's 21, and Christopher is 17 now.
As their three children move out, Carrie and Mark are ready to move on.
So pretty soon we're going to be empty nesters with this huge house, five bedrooms, and just the two of us.
The couple wants to move somewhere with warmer weather, but at least for now, that dream is on hold because their mortgage is upside down.
What's the difference between your mortgage and the appraised value?
Roughly about $50,000.
Carrie told me their home was recently appraised at $238,000. They owe $289,000.
Shocked, disappointed, you know, very disappointed that I could think that we probably wouldn't be able to sell it.
The Gowardis aren't alone. In fact, nearly 19% of homeowners in Lackawanna County are in a similar situation, with mortgages that are seriously underwater. But in parts of the Poconos, the statistics are even more staggering. Monroe County ranks 7th in the nation for homes with market values that are at least 25% lower than the balance remaining on the mortgages. To put that in perspective, the national average is about 9%, but in Monroe County, it's almost 27%, meaning more than 1 in 4 homes are upside down. Those numbers are from Adam Data Solutions. I talked to Senior Vice President of Communications Darren Bloomquist on Skype. He says we're still seeing remnants of the Great Recession from a decade ago.
In most parts of the country, that issue has subsided because home prices have risen pretty dramatically in a lot of parts of the country. But we do still see some markets kind of left behind.
While the local economy is part of the problem, there's another issue: property taxes. According to Adam Data Solutions, Pennsylvania had the 6th highest property tax rates in 2017.
It can drag down home price appreciation, which keeps more people in this state of having negative equity or being underwater on their homes.
It's something Amy Cosentino, a real estate agent with Century 21 Select Group in Blakeslee, deals with every day.
The property taxes are definitely high. You know, I've seen them around here $5,000, $6,000, $7,000, $8,000 a year. So and then you have homeowners association fees on top of that.
Have you seen people in situations where their taxes are more than their mortgage?
Oh yeah, all the time.
Amy specializes in short sales, a possible solution for people trapped in debt-logged homes.
In a short sale, I'll work directly with the homeowner's lender to get the lender to release the liens and sell the property for less than what's owed on the property.
She says past due taxes, HOA fees, even some utility bills can also be negotiated in a short sale, and the homeowner doesn't have to pay the typical closing costs that come with selling a property.
It's better for your credit to do a short sale than go through a foreclosure or a bankruptcy. Most people can repair their credit in about 2 years of doing a short sale.
That being said, a homeowner needs a valid hardship to qualify for a short sale, like losing a job or the death of a spouse. Amy told me many of her applicants get approved, but for Carrie and Mark, who are fortunate to have good jobs and able to make their mortgage payments, all they can do is try to bulk up their savings and stay focused on the future. Because even though they feel stuck in their upside-down dilemma, they know it could always be worse.
I'm sure there are a lot of people out there who aren't as blessed as we are.
If you have an upside-down mortgage, we'll post the contact information for the real estate agent over on our website, PAHomepage.com. That's also where you'll find a chart that shows how your community compares to surrounding areas. Live for the iTeam tonight, Kelly Choate, Eyewitness News.
Wow, amazing, Kelly. I had no idea there were this many people in our area in that situation.
It can happen quickly, too, from what it sounds like. Now, if you have a story idea for the iTeam, you can find Eyewitness News on Facebook or Twitter. Just send us a message.